How are you?
I'm well. I'm so glad we get to talk. Can you talk a little bit about how you bring everyday data to people's lives? Because I've seen some of your posts. I know my daughter follows you. Like, what got you into that, and how are you doing that more?
Yeah, so I come from a data background. I'm an economist. My work is about data, and actually a lot of my academic work was about women, is about women's health, including in the developing world. When I got pregnant, I sort of turned at least some of my attention to looking at the data around pregnancy and parenting, and then got really passionate about trying to bring those data to people in a way that they could understand and make more empowering decisions for themselves. So it's really a combination of what I love in my academic work and what I care about in terms of bringing information to people in the world.
Well, I have to tell you, when a few people in my office heard that I was doing this recording with you, moms and dads were like, oh, we follow Emily. Like, that, she's the person that we all follow and get our information from. So you're totally popular in my office.
Well, that's very nice. I am so interested to talk to you about the Goalkeepers Report, because this really goes back to the topics I thought about before I got into writing about parenting, which is women's health and women's health in the developing world. And I guess the thing that really struck me is a lot of what you talk about are interventions that we know work and that in some ways are so simple, and yet we're not doing them. And so I'm interested to hear both about what do you think are the most important game-changing innovations in the maternal health space, and why are they not yet implemented?
Yeah. Yeah, I think, you know, we finally have woken up to the fact that so many women still die in childbirth, and they just shouldn't. The UN set a goal in 2030 to reduce those deaths, and we're not only not on track, but in the U.S., you know, we lose so many women in childbirth. So one of the things we tried to do in the Goalkeepers Report this year was highlight, like, what's possible. So some of these interventions are not hard, like azithromycin, which is a drug that many of us use and use with our children. If you give that to a woman during pregnancy, she's much less likely to die of sepsis. So azithromycin is inexpensive. It's easy to give. Another one is IV iron. Giving women iron not only can stave off depression, but it can also reduce her chance of hemorrhage. And so many women hemorrhage during childbirth. So they're really simple things that we just need to make sure actually get rolled out in our healthcare system. When you look at your work, do you feel like data has been sexist in a certain way?
Data is pretty sexist. I mean, there are like some very like almost institutionalized reasons for that, at least in the U.S. You know, for a long time, there were basically restrictions almost against putting women in trials for drugs because they could be pregnant. And that's still, you know, to some extent true. We saw it in the trials of the COVID vaccines that didn't include pregnant women. Then it turned out that's actually probably a group that would benefit more than many other people from vaccination. But because they weren't in the trials, the messaging was complicated, and we ended up with actually a lot of mortality as a result of that. So, I mean, I think we have to be increasingly careful about representation in trials and representation in drug development.
One of the things that I really like is that you're an economist. One of the things that I've really felt is that we need more women in some fields that we haven't had as many women in before, particularly in economics, because I think brings a different perspective. I know Claudia Golden won the Nobel Prize in economics. I could have shouted from the rooftops when I saw that, because, you know, that workplace gender issues that she's highlighting is so important. She's a friend of yours. Tell me, as an economist, and even just as a mom, what does it mean to have Claudia win the Nobel Prize?
I mean, I also shot, like, I was out for a run. I get this notification on my phone. I basically, like, booked it back to my house, and my husband was in the shower. I was like, did you see who won? He's like, yes, I saw. I mean, Claudia is groundbreaking. I mean, she's groundbreaking as a scholar, is the first thing. Like, her sense of data and her insights, if you read some of her early books, it's like you're reading something that, you know, 40 years later, she kind of had all those ideas. But she also was working on these topics at a time in which people didn't think this was economics, in which it didn't think that, you know, didn't think of this as something that we would care about studying. And the field has moved. I wish it had moved more, but it has moved to a place where at least some of that stuff is kind of considered more a mainstream part of what we talk about. And I think Claudia is just credited for that and for the willingness to work on those topics at a time when people thought that was like, who cares? You know, who cares about ladies and their jobs? And, you know, she cared about ladies and their jobs. And she also is, I think it's worth saying, just about the most important advisor for such a large share of women in the profession. I mean, I think there's so many people who can trace back their excitement about economics, their willingness to stick with it to Claudia. So it was just like, it was just really, it's really special.
Yeah. Well, and to have, I think, females win these big scholarly awards for their scholarship, but they bring a different perspective. And for so long, economics, you know, some of these topics, like unpaid work, for instance, was considered soft, a soft issue. And yet we know it contributes massively to the economy and that you actually can measure it. It just wasn't measured before because the men were the economists at the time and they measured things they saw in the workplace, right? So to have women bringing, you know, groundbreaking work to economics.
No, it's true. And I think that it really was sort of the men were seeing, like, they just weren't seeing this. They weren't seeing what people were doing as work. They saw what they were doing was work. And it sort of took someone coming from a different perspective to say, hey, you know what? You're not looking at the full picture. And this is the full picture. And we need to think about the supports that are going to help women succeed in the workplace. And, you know, Claudia has done so much work on that. And so, you know, so many others. And it's, I think we're making a little progress.
Yeah.
There's more to go.
As an economist, did you ever think you would be giving parenting advice?
No. I mean, it's like someone asked me the other day, like, you know, if yourself 10 years ago could look at yourself now, what would you say? And I was just like, I have no idea. I mean, it's really, it's been kind of an interesting ride, but I feel like it's where I'm supposed to be.
Yeah, I think it's funny. We end up in these places in life, right? And you think, well, maybe my voice will give way to something that I didn't even know was there. Well, I'm so glad we got a chance to talk today.
Likewise, this was such a treat. I really appreciate everything you've done. And the Goalkeepers Report is great and really, really important.
Nice to meet you, Emily.
Nice to meet you, too.
Bye.